Hey, what's up everyone? Passive Baller here. Good morning to everyone. Nandito po ngayon tayo to talk about the MPBL predictions that we have. And today is July 8 ba ngayon? 6. July 8, 2024. And we have three games for today. Starting off with the first game, that's going to be 4 o'clock p.m. But before we do that, I'm just inviting everyone who have not subscribed yet to our YouTube account or YouTube channel, Pase Baller. Please click on the subscribe button below. At the same time, hit on that bell logo. That way, automatically, you guys will be receiving notifications whenever new videos are uploaded. By the way, for those who are interested to subscribe to our best picks or to our premium picks for MLB or for baseball, you can actually reach us through Instagram, Telegram, WhatsApp, or even Messenger account. Just take a look at the descriptions in the just take a look at the details in the descriptions of the videos below. All right. So, pag-usapan natin yung first game natin. It's gonna be Valenzuela XUR Homes Realty Incorporated going up against Sarangani Province. That'll happen at 4 o'clock p.m. And the spread that is given here is -6.5, and that's given towards Valenzuela. Now, let's take a quick look dun sa standings itong dalawang teams na to. Starting with Valenzuela, they are at number 16 overall in MPBL. At the moment, they have a record of 9 wins and 8 losses. Tapos itong Sarangani naman, they are at number 25 with the record of 4 wins and 12 losses. So obviously, Valenzuela has a better record. And not only that, Valenzuela has actually won back-to-back approaching this game. So they have the better record. They have some momentum. Tapos ito namang Sarangani, they are struggling, obviously, 4 wins and 12 losses. But just like what I said in the previous videos that I had with Sarangani, they took a huge boost sa kanilang lineup, sa kanilang performance mula nung dumating yung kanilang mga bagong recruits led by Marvin Hayes. Yun nga lang, natalo sila dun sa previous game nila, but the game before that, they actually did well. So for the last three games, naka isang panalo pa lang sila. So again, in terms of momentum, it favors yung Valenzuela. But of course, pinag-usapan naman natin dito is yung coverage, which is 6.5, di ba? -6.5 ang nakabigay kay Valenzuela. And Valenzuela, they have actually won back-to-back, di ba? And they are actually doing good in terms of their record. Above 500% naman sila. Pero if there's one thing that hindi ko nakikita sa Valenzuela is yung pagdiit, if you know what I mean. Noong nakaraan, nanalo sila, di ba? Back-to-back na sila. Nanalo sila against Muntinlupa. And they only won by 2 points. They almost lost that game, actually. Tinambakan pa nga sila ng Muntinlupa. And Muntinlupa was the underdog. Yung game before that, they defeated Bacolod. And during that game, 8 lang yung players ng Bacolod. Naging 7 na nga lang because of an injury. So, tapos, it ended up na 7 lang ang lamang nila. So, medyo nakukulangan lang ako sa pagdiin. But really, malakas ng Valenzuela. Ang ganda ng lineup nila. Andyan si Hubalde, di ba? Denny Santos. Ang dami, marami sila. Lumakas sila eh. Lumakas pa lalo sila. Maganda rin ang coaching staff nila. Pero yun na nga, not sure kung medyo nag-relax kasi sila towards the end. Lalo na pag lamang silang malaki. O yun nga, when they went up against Muntinlupa, medyo they took Muntinlupa lightly nung umpisa, kaya medyo Muntinlupa actually took the lead and managed the game for the first three quarters. Third quarter na lang talaga nakahabol yung Valenzuela. At muntik pa talaga silang manalo ng Muntinlupa nun. Pumalag pa yung Muntinlupa hanggang sa last 2 minutes, diba? So, yun yung nakukulangan ako sa Valenzuela. And if you take a look at Sarangani, since medyo nag-boost na rin yung kanilang lineup, I'll go ahead and take Sarangani on this. Yes, Valenzuela may win, but along with the last 2 wins that they had, baka maging close lang din to. So, I'll go ahead and take Sarangani with the plus 6.5. Okay? Again, on the first game, our pick would be Sarangani plus 6.5. Now, let's proceed with our next game. Isipan na naman ako. Rizal Golden Coolers going up against Negros Muscovados. That will be at 6 o'clock p.m. Philippine time. Yung ating spread is at minus 4.5. Okay? Minus 4.5. So let's take a look at the spread. I mean the spread. Yun na pala yung spread. Let's take a look at the standings, di ba? Starting with Rizal. Lagi akong sinisipag kung kailan ako mag-video. Rizal. Where the hell is Rizal? There you go. So Rizal, they have a record of 9 wins and 7 losses. Tapos ito namang si Negros. And by the way, Rizal is at number 15. Diba? So they are at the upper half naman ng tournament. While Negros, they are currently at number 19 dito sa MPBL with the record of 6 wins and 10 losses. Okay? Both teams coming off wins naman. Pero medyo mas mainit ng konti si Negros kasi naka-back-to-back wins sila approaching this game. And again, the spread is minus 4.5. This is gonna be tough sa totoo lang kasi Rizal is a good team. Kita nyo naman, number 15 sila out of 29 teams, diba? Pero yung Negros, I have a lot of respect with Negros, lalo na with Palma. With Palma there, sabayan lang siya ng isa o dalawa pang players na maganda ang offense for that particular game. Negros is gonna be such a team to beat, diba? Tapos marami pa silang malaki, sa totoo lang. Kaya hindi ganun kadali kalaban ng Negros eh, di ba? Kahit na ganun yung record nila, kahit na nasa lower half sila ng tournament, hindi sila ganun kadaling talunin. Plus yung Rizal, ang problem ko with Rizal is they're so inconsistent. They're so inconsistent. Just when you thought na medyo okay na sila, just when you thought na medyo may momentum na sila, magkakalat naman sila. Alam mo yun? Ang hirap nila basahin, ang hirap nila pagkatiwalaan in terms of betting kasi yun na nga, they are so inconsistent. Halos hindi mo pwedeng gamitin na factor sa kanila yung momentum eh. Kasi kahit na, yes, may momentum sila, but yung susunod na laban against maybe a relatively weaker team, struggle naman sila. So, ang hirap eh. Tapos yun nga, yung Negros, just like what I said, they are on back-to-back wins, so may momentum yan sila. And I really respect yung lineup ng Negros. You really need to work hard to beat them. So on this one, I'll go ahead and pick Negros Muscovados with the plus 4.5. I'm pretty sure that they are pumped up. They are very confident right now with those back-to-back wins. Although, syempre, iba, yung skill set na meron ng Rizal is different from those two wins that Negros has. I think Negros has the capability to make this one close, okay? So our pick on the second game would be Negros Muscovados plus 4.5. Ako yung sinisip po na talaga. Excuse me? Okay, so, sorry. Yung ating third game, saan na yun? Ito itong sipon ko eh. Davao Occidental Tigers going up against Paranaque Patriots. Ang spread that is given is minus 3.5 and that's given towards Davao. Let's take a look at yung standings itong dalawang teams na to. Pareho silang nasa top 10. Diba? Pareho silang nasa top 10. Starting with Davao Occidental, their record is at 10 wins and 5 losses. While for Paranaque, they are at number 10 tied with Abra. And their record is 10 wins and 6 losses. So lumamang lang ng one half game itong Davao kay Paranaque Patriots. Ano ulit yung spread? Minus 3.5. Tapos yung minus na yon. Bayan. Sorry talaga. Sorry talaga guys. Nisipon ako. Kagabi pa. Tapos yung minus na yon, that's given towards Davao. So sila pa pala talaga yung ano. Sila pa talaga yung merong spread. And I agree. I agree naman doon. Kahit ako, pag papipiliin mo, I think Davao is the one with the upper hand right here. Okay, yun nga lang. This one's gonna be tough kasi Paranaque will be at home. Diba? Paranaque will be at home and of course, isa to sa mga teams na talagang support. Is Paranaque gonna be at home? Nalututuloy ako. Wait lang ah. Alam ko Paranaque yung ano eh. Para niya kaya home dito sa araw na to. Let me just double check. Mamaya mali ako. Nagigising ko lang guys, sorry. Saan na siya? Yes, Olivares ang laban. So tama ako. That's the advantage that Paranaque has. They will be at home. And Paranaque is one of those teams na widely supported ng kanilang home crowd, 'di ba? Halos laging puno 'yan eh, kahit na weekday. Halos laging puno 'yan. And of course, that boosts yung Paranaque team. And Paranaque has maybe, I don't know, like a couple or maybe three players na Paranaque native. So that's gonna be laki talaga ng hatak nun eh, di ba? May mga players na talagang taga Paranaque. Kaya marami rin yung supporta ninyo. But going back to the game, I know half a game lang yung ahead ng Davao, but Davao is such a deep rotation. They are coming off that loss against the Caloocan, 3 points, pero I'm sure they learned a lot on that game. Caloocan is an uprising team. Hindi mo talaga pwedeng i-take for granted kahit na sinong team. And after losing such a game, I'm pretty sure that Davao will come here well prepared. I'm actually expecting Davao to win more than 3 points, more than 4 points, you know. It's not going to be like a blowout, but even if Paranaque is at home, even if Paranaque is actually gaining some momentum, I expect Davao to win by maybe more than 5 points, more than 6 points. Yung minus 3.5 for me, napakaliit yan for such an angry tiger, kumbaga. Davao Tigers daw sila. An angry tiger after losing to Davao. I mean, after losing to Caloocan. Yung Davao lineup, makikita ninyo, ang dami niyang ex-PBA. Malalim pa yung bench nila. Okay din ng, mas okay din ng kanilang coaching staff. So, I mean, no disrespect kay Paranaque, but I know they will bring a fight. But on this one, I'm gonna put my money on Davao Occidental, even with a minus 3.5. Okay? So again, our pick on the main event will be Davao Occidental Tigers minus 3.5. And those are the predictions that we have for today. Ingat po tayo, konting disiplina sa paglagay ng mga pusta. Not sure kung kayo yung nagpadala noon, but I received an amount last Saturday. Maybe it was a tip, but wala kasing message or whatsoever. Pero salamat kung sino man yon, salamat. Sana meron din mag-tip today. Okay? Peace out. Pass I love and God bless.